Hello students, welcome to Asia's Young IAS. So here we discuss very important topics for you from prelims perspective. Okay, so we take up topics from current affairs which are very important from prelims perspective, and we discuss it here in short. Okay, so that you can gather important facts about that particular topic. So today's topic is Gaganyaan. Okay, so let's see why Gaganyaan was in news. So it was in news because Russia will train 2 flight surgeons from India. Okay, previously it was said that Russia is going to train Indian astronauts, but now Russia will also train 2 flight surgeons from India in space medicine for the Gaganyaan missions. So who will be those flight surgeons? So these doctors will be, first of all, from the Indian Air Force, who have specialized in aerospace medicine. So they will be picked up from the Indian Air Force. And secondly, these doctors will be responsible for astronauts' overall health before the mission, during the mission, as well as after the mission. Okay, so before going on the flight, the astronauts will be checked for their health by these doctors, and while they are on the mission, while they are on the flight, the doctors are going to accompany them and check their health over there. And after coming back from the flight, again their health will be checked up by these doctors. So there will be 2 doctors on the Gaganyaan mission, and these 2 doctors are going to be trained by Russia. Hence Gaganyaan was in news. So you need to know important facts about Gaganyaan that could come in your examination. So first of all, Gaganyaan, which is the Indian Human Space Flight Program. Okay, Indian Human Space Flight Program, इसी को नाम दिया गया है योर Gaganyaan मिशन. ओके, सो इसरो एम्स टू लॉन्च इट्स मेडन ह्यूमन, मेडन मतलब फर्स्ट. ओके, सो फर्स्ट ह्यूमन स्पेस मिशन होगा ये इंडिया का, विच विल बी लॉन्च बाय आर इसरो, इंडियन स्पेस रिसर्च ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, एंड इट इज नेम्ड एज Gaganyaan. Okay, so it will be launched before our 75th independence anniversary. Okay, 75th independence हम जब celebrate करेंगे, उससे पहले हमें ये space mission launch करना है. That is before 2022. Okay, so what's the basic knowledge we can get from the Gaganyaan mission is that its orbital module will consist of 7 days in space. So 3 astronauts are going to stay in space, okay, for 7 days. Now there is a crew module. What is a crew module? So here you can see the triangular thing. This is the crew module where the astronauts are going to live for 7 days. Okay, so this is their home for 7 days in the space, this brown thing. Okay, it is the habitat of astronaut. Habitat means home, where they are going to stay in the space for 7 whole days. And then you have the service module, which will do an orbit servicing. Ye aapka service module ho jata hai. Okay, and ye aapka human rated launch vehicle hai, jahan se wo mission launch hoga. So here you can see this thing, the crew module and the service module. Here it is, and it will be launched by the GSLV MK3 mission. Okay, so this is the basic info you should know about the Gaganyaan mission. Okay, crew module where the astronauts are going to live, and service module will do the orbit servicing. Fine, 7 days they will spend in the space, and overall 3 astronauts can go in there. Now after a brief introduction about Gaganyaan, let's see some more details about it. So it is a crewed orbital spacecraft. Crewed matlab kya hota, we are going to send astronauts in this mission, a crewed orbital mission, a crewed orbital spacecraft. So Gaganyaan is a crewed orbital spacecraft that is expected to take 3 astronauts. Okay, ye humne piche bhi dekha tha, right? So 3 astronauts are going to stay in the space for 7 days. So 3 astronauts will be staying for 7 days in the space, and GSLV is going to be used for this mission. Again, in the previous slide we have already seen that. So GSLV, that is geosynchronous launch vehicle, is going to launch the Gaganyaan mission, and this spacecraft will be placed in low earth orbit of 300 to 400 kilometer. Okay, so all these important facts can be asked in your examination. First of all, whether it is crewed or not. Then if it is crewed, then how many astronauts will be sent, for how many days. Okay, then which launch vehicle will be used? Geosynchronous launch vehicle is going to be used. Okay, then where it will be placed? Low earth orbit ya dusre orbit mein rakhenge, so it is the low earth orbit. Fine. So it will be India's first manned space flight mission, we know this. Kitne crew honge? There will be 3 astronauts. What is the cost? 9,023 crore rupees. What will be the duration of the mission? Max to max 7 days. Okay, so between 5 to 7 days it has been counted. What is the aim of the mission? The aim of the mission is to open opportunities for research and development in science and technology in various areas like medicine, agriculture, industrial safety, pollution and waste management, so that we can enrich ourselves with all kind of R&Ds in these fields. This is the main aim of the mission. Okay, along with water and food resource management. Okay, so now the timeline of the mission. So there will be 3 missions in this main mission. There will be 3 sub missions. One mission in December 2020, which is already done. Then one mission in June 2021, and one mission in December 2021. So these 2 missions, December 2020 wala and June 2021 wala, both of these missions are unmanned flight. That means no crew will be there. Okay, so in December 2020 it was planned that one unmanned flight, iska naam hoga Vyomamitra. Okay, half humanoid robot will be sent in this flight. That is, a robot will be sent in December 2020, it was planned. Then in June 2021, again one unmanned space flight will be sent, and after these 2 successful experiments, we are going to send a crewed mission, a manned flight, in December 2021, that is this year. Now due to the pandemic, this has been delayed. Okay, so this was the whole plan of Gaganyaan mission, that what it is, what it involves, and what are the 3 sub missions. So before sending astronauts into the space, we are going to send unmanned flight, 2 unmanned flight before that. Okay, then what is the significance of our Gaganyaan mission? So if India successfully sends the 4 astronauts or the 3 astronauts, whatever we say, to space, it will be only the 4th nation to do so. That is only the 4th nation to send. Okay, it is 3 astronauts actually. Okay, the 4th nation to do so after United States, China and Russia. So abhi tak sirf aur sirf yahi 3 countries astronauts bhej chuki hai space mein. So if India is successful, then it will be the 4th nation in the world to send astronauts in the space after US, China and Russia. So again yahan pe bhi ek question banta hai ki which of the following countries have sent astronauts into the space? US, China, Russia, England, okay, France, Canada, India. 4, 5, 6, 7 countries aapko de denge, and you have to choose which of these countries have sent astronauts in the space. Fine. Then another significance of Gaganyaan mission is that it will re-establish India's space research position amongst giants such as the US, China, Russia, which spends way more money than India on space programs. Even if you have seen ki Chandrayaan mission jo hamare hai, uska cost in comparison to US, China and Russia was very very less. Okay, so for our space missions, India spends very less money as compared to these 3 countries. Again, a question can be formed over here that whether India spends more money or less money than the other countries for its space missions. So India spends very less as compared to US, China and Russia. So this was the significance of Gaganyaan mission. Now after that, what is the Russian connection? So first of all, one connection we have already seen in the first slide, that is why Gaganyaan was in news. Okay, Russia is going to train two doctors who will be accompanying the astronauts. Okay, so the Russian connection is that the first of all, ISRO have signed an agreement with Russia's Glavkosmos. So the Glavkosmos is going to train Indian astronauts for the space mission. Okay, so overall 12 astronauts will be sent to Russia. Okay, 12 astronauts are going to be trained in Russia, and out of these 12 astronauts, 4 will be shortlisted. Only 4 astronauts will be shortlisted for the purpose. Now, these selected astronauts will going to undergo a rigorous training for another 15 months. Okay, it will be in India as well as in abroad. 12 में से सिर्फ 4 astronauts को select किया जाएगा, and after that उनको भी 15 महीने के लिए और ज़्यादा rigorous training दी जाएगी India में भी और दूसरी countries में भी including Russia. So this is the Russia connection. Now another Russia connection is that if you know Rakesh Sharma, okay, India's only astronaut to travel in space, Rakesh Sharma. So he also undertook his journey in Russia's Intercosmos program. So Intercosmos program Russia ka space program tha. It was a collaboration between ISRO and Russia. So Rakesh Sharma was the only Indian who was traveling in that mission. Okay, and till date he has been the only one who has traveled in that Russian spacecraft. Fine. So India's first man in space, it is Rakesh Sharma. So in 1966 he joined NDA as an Air Force cadet. Then 1970 में उसे as a pilot IAF में induct किया गया, commission किया गया. Then in 1984 Rakesh Sharma became the first Indian to travel in space as part of a joint effort between ISRO and the Soviet Union. So he spent 7 days 21 hours and 40 minutes aboard the Salyut 7 orbital station belonging to Russia. Okay, so again this is the Russian connection which India have in relation to space. Okay, now after that, how will this manned mission will work? How will Gaganyaan work? So first of all, we are going to launch it from our GSLV MK3, okay, from Sriharikota. Sriharikota से हम GSLV MK3 यूज करके हम इसे लॉन्च करेंगे. Then it will take around 16 minutes to reach the low earth orbit. We are going to launch it in low earth orbit, right? So to reach that low earth orbit, it is going to take 16 minutes. Okay, after that it will be going into the orbit module thing. उसके बाद सोलर एले डिप्लॉयमेंट होगा, एंड व्हेन इट इज डिप्लॉयड इट विल बी स्पेंडिंग 5 to 7 days इन स्पेस. एंड आफ्टर स्पेंडिंग 5 to 7 days इन स्पेस अगेन इट विल बी रीओरिएंटेड टुवर्ड्स अर्थ. ओके, सो द मॉड्यूल विल चेंज इट्स डायरेक्शन, इट विल बी रीओरिएंटेड टुवर्ड्स अर्थ. ओके, देन द सेपरेशन ऑफ क्रू एंड सर्विस मॉड्यूल्स विल टेक प्लेस. दैट इज द क्रू मॉड्यूल विल एंटर इन टू अर्थ्स orbit or earth's atmosphere. Then aero braking will take place, parachute deployment hoga, then jo astronauts hai, they will take the parachutes and land down. Okay, so they will be splash downing at Arabian Sea of Gujarat. Ultimately we will get our astronauts back. So this is the whole outlay of the mission, that how it's going to work. Okay, now what's the relevance of Gaganyaan mission? Okay, relevance kya hai Gaganyaan mission ka? So first of all, if successful, the Gaganyaan mission is going to give a boost to industries. Okay, the Indian industry will find large opportunities through participation in the highly demanding space mission. All right, after that, next relevance is employment. So according to ISRO, this mission, Gaganyaan mission, is going to create 15,000 new employment opportunities according to ISRO. Okay, it is said that 13,000 of these 15,000 new opportunities are going to be in private industry. Okay, and for this purpose, the space organization, that is our space organization ISRO, is going to need an additional manpower of 900 people. That is, the mission is going to create a huge employment pool. Okay, next relevance is technological development. So these flights like Gaganyaan, these flights are frontier field in science and technology. Okay, so the challenges that are before humans play its flights, it will provide benefits for taking up those missions, and it will be very high, and it will lead to further thrust for technological developments in India. So we are going to take up all these challenges, and we are going to develop more and more of such mission. Hence, our technology is going to be advanced. Okay, next relevance of Gaganyaan is that it spurs research and development. So it is going to boost good research and technology. Okay, so with a large number of researchers who will be given proper equipment. Okay, so this human space flight will thrust significant research in areas like processing of materials, okay, astrobiology, or resource mining, or planetary chemistry, ya fir dusra jo orbital calculus hota hai, planetary orbital calculus, etc., etc. So it is going to spur R&D into all these fields. Next relevance is motivation. Okay, so this flight called Gaganyaan is going to provide an inspiration to the youth of our country, and also to the national public mainstream. That is, people will aspire to go into the space and work with ISRO. It is kind of motivation to them. Okay, so it would inspire young generation into notable achievements and enable them to play their legitimate role in challenging future activities. Okay, so more and more astronauts you can see in future that are coming from India. And last relevance of Gaganyaan is that it is going to give us a lot of prestige. India will be the fourth country to launch human space mission, okay, after Russia, US and China. So it is a matter of prestige for India ki puri duniya mein India sirf aur sirf chauthi aisi country hai who is going to send astronauts into the space. Okay, so the Gaganyaan will not only bring about prestige to the nation, but also establish India's role as a key player in the space industry. Okay, so that was all about Gaganyaan mission. Hope it was informative and will help in your prelims examination. Thank you for watching with this video, and we'll come with more videos like this to help you clearing your examination. Okay, thank you so much.